You hear those voices too, right?
Yes. Be silent.
That sounds like the same man who came to our house. You said you killed him.
Shh. I see you brought company this time. Must be important if the sons of Thor deign to grace me with their presence. Tell me, you two still tripping over yourselves to impress Daddy?
The tattooed man. Tracks show he now travels with a child. Where would they go next?
Why would I know that?
You're the smartest man alive, aren't you?
Smarter than all the dead ones, too.
You help me, I help you. Tell me where they are, and I'll talk to Odin.
Your father won't let me go, Baldur, and he won't let you kill me. You have nothing to offer me. So take your questions, take your threats, take these two worthless wankers, and piss off!
When no one's looking, we'll be back for your other eye.
Don't you forget, we're everywhere.
We really are, aren't we?
Ah, the very topic of conversation. A tattooed man traveling with a child.
Boy took their path. Make sure we're all alone.
But we just saw them leave.
Do as I say.
He doesn't know what you are.
And I would keep it that way. Who are you?
Me? I'm the greatest ambassador to the gods, the giants, and all the creatures of the Nine Realms. I know every corner of these lands, every language spoken, every war waged, every deal struck. They call me Mimir, smartest man alive. And I have the answer to your every question.
Why does the son of Odin hunt us?
Okay, there are a few gaps in my knowledge. But Odin's had me imprisoned here for 109 winters. I'm a clever lad. I can piece it together. Promise. Given time.
Nobody there, just like I said.
The boy's mother is dead. She wished her.
She wanted us to spread her ashes on the highest peak in all the realms.
Oh, then you've come to the wrong place, little brother. The highest peak in all the realms is not here in Midgard. It's in Jotunheim, realm of the giants.
No!
That could not be what she meant.
Take a look. This is the last known bridge to Jotunheim in all the realms. See that mountain? Looks like a giant's finger scraping the sky. That's the highest peak in all the realms. No here.
Can't we just take that bridge? We have a Bifrost.
When the giants destroyed all other bridges to their realm, they locked this one up with a secret rune. If it still exists, only a giant would know it.
And all of them left Midgard a long time ago.
True. But today, the winds of fate have kicked up a strange vortex of coincidence. Fact is, there's only one person alive who can get you where you need to go. And luckily for you, my schedule's wide open.
We're going to Jotunheim, right?
It's your best and only move from a tactical standpoint. It's the one place the man who cannot be killed won't follow you.
What do we do?
Yes!
First, you need to cut off my head.
Wait, what?
Odin made sure that no weapon, not even Thor's hammer, could free my body from these bonds. But fortunately, you don't need my body. The trick is, we need to find someone who can reanimate my head using the old magic.
Old magic? There's a witch of the woods. She knows the old ways.
And she'll help. She might do. Worth a try.
But if she fails, he will be dead.
He tortures me, you know. Every day, brother. Odin himself sees to it personally, and believe me, there is no end to his creativity. Every single day. This isn't living.
Very well.
Oh, I can't watch this.
Brother. In case you can't resurrect me, there's something you need to know. The boy, the longer you wait to tell him his true nature, the more damage you do. He will resent you, and you may lose him forever.
There is much about me I would not have him know.
So you value your privacy more than your son?
I'm going to cut off your head now.
Fair enough.
Realm of the Giants. That's
inconvenient.
Yeah, that's just what I was going to say. So this is the bridge to Jotunheim? This looks like those weird doors we've seen. I guess Mimir will help us figure it all out. If we can bring him back to life.
To the witch's house.
Yes. The woods with the blood red leaves. South of the lake. I know just where to go. Hope she made it back from Alfheim and can bring Mimir back. He seemed nice. Before you cut off his head. Look at this place. This must be a branch of the World Tree.
Boy, stay on the path.
Right, right, I know. I can't believe it was Baldur that came to our house. The Aesir god. Baldur! And you fought him, and won!
Yes.
One of Odin's sons, Thor's brother. And now he's hunting us with his nephews. Why is this happening?
If we can raise the head, you can ask him.
Okay. You know, it's silly, but I secretly hope we find a giant somewhere in that mountain. I guess they really did leave Midgard, except for the serpent. Maybe the last of his kind. Are you the last of your kind, too? Is that why you don't like to talk about
my kind?
I mean, your family. Before Mother, where you came from. Mother, a father?
Now is not the time for that.
Yes, sir.
Fucking break! Don't hear me screeching at you whenever you're twiddling your short and curlies.
Leave him, boy.
No, Fred. Well, you already soiled my solitude, so you may as well join me.
You're not hungry.
Good. It's not what I was offering.
Saw your brother again.
Congratulations. And I'm sure you'll let him go and Roger my axe good and plenty again, Let's see the damage. Little canker throat wouldn't know proper weight and balance if it were dangling off his chut. Is he eating well enough?
I guess.
Good. All better. Now what the fuck else you want, huh? Times he gets so wrapped up in his work, Sentry hasn't the sense to sip us up. And if he does remember, good luck getting him to cook his own meat. Guess I got all the stomach in the family. Along with the smarts.
You miss him.
What, that spitfister? What do you know?
I just mean
hey,
that...
do you mind? Trying to concentrate here, already on a break from my break. Time for another... break anyways.
What is the path back to the witch?
First, we need to find a boat.
Do you remember the way back to the witch from here?
That way, behind the big statue of Thor. Story.
Very well. There was a young man who was caught stealing and condemned to die. His mother came to visit his prison. She was a kind woman who could only give love. But her son, the thief, met her with rage and bit off her ear.
What? Why?
Because the boy had always been a thief, and his mother had taught him only love. and nothing of consequences. Had he been taught discipline instead, he might have lived longer.
Sure, but her ear, that's not right. Got any more short and purposeful stories from it?
Very well. There was the story of the mother crab, who scolded her son. She told him he should walk forward, in pride, not sideways as he always did.
But she's a crab too. You should say, sure. I'll look for it as soon as you show me how.
Yes. He did say that. That was the story.
I got it. know she's really powerful, but you really think the witch can bring the head back to life?
She seems competent in her craft, and we have nothing to lose.
If she can't bring it back to life, can we keep the head?
No. But you may feed it to the fish.
Okay. I bet this will lead out. Hey, this does more than decipher those Muspelheim runes. It also contains the travel rune. Should we go visit the fire realm?
Atreus, to me!
How'd I do?
Adequate.
This is locked up good.
Look here.
It's another one of those maps.
Takes care of that. Hey, see another one of those boulders stand up. Can I dig the ruins into? Not sure how we reach it. Okay, well, that's way too far to jump. This'll be fun. Almost there! I can't jump over with those wooden boards in the way. Sandballs. There are different runes written along the side of this one.
What does it say?
Another riddle. Feed me not, we both are doomed. And when you feed me, I'll consume.
The answer might be near, like the other.
I see it now. It says fire. Of course. Bow.
Turn back Aesir. Guess the gods aren't welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us.
Over here.
This is good to know.
Thank you.
How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie. They were harder than I thought.
Atreus, to me.
Okay, I'm coming.
Can you read it?
Sir. Death to the Raven God, Lord of the Hanged.
Read it.
Yes, sir. Say their needings upon all who trespass.
Want to see what we can trade those for?
Oh.
Here, boy.
I know those runes. That's Vinder. Wind. Must be for that sand bowl down there.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above. Ah, wind. Vinder.
Look what it did!
Father, she is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hamelin! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either? Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are god.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
now.
You're welcome.
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Or have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The World Serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
I wish Mom were here.
Thank you.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spit in your face?
No. Speak. Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
The boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're on the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. Alphic.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why you? Realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
Is that one of the people who first met you?
correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. Now forgive me, I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
Got another favor to ask you, Jim.
What do you want, dwarf?
I got another lead on my old pal Anvari. Meet me at the Lawn Soother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain at the mines. These ones is just south of the river pass. Now you two want something, or you just gonna stand there all gag-scrapped and slack-jawed? Pull the ring off Anvari's hand at the Velander Mines. Feller was always tampering with souls and dark rituals and matters of the night, see? Just the sound of his hammer flattening metal were enough to stoke my fires all blissful. Shit, you better clear out before I get all frisky. Something for the boy? What else? Now, what was the other thing? What's got you all bum-fuzzled over there? Get going!
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Way to the chisel.
Boat under the bridge, keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir have proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, Legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Well, looky who decided to show. Talk to this here ring.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brock. It's talking to me! It's Unvari!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake. But then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff? Unvari had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools. And one beaut of a hammer. He make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Unvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your entry stone.
Unvari isn't happy about us taking his stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that. I did okay, yeah?
I see improvement. Follow me, Atreus.
Envari says this dwarf was part of his crew. And he died because of his mistakes. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
Did not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. Cannot be trusted.
silence that ring, boy.
I don't know how! A soul eater.
And a traveler. Guard up. Here, boy.
Treasure map. All right.
Thank you. show it to the dwarves.
Had us. A dead soul eater. What's a soul eater even doing here? What do you mean it's your fault?
Boy, ignore him.
It's sort of tough for me to ignore. He says this chest will trigger a bunch of traps.
I see no traps.
Sounded so sure about it.
Whoa!
Watch out, Father!
Just listen. Invari's crew did something bad here. He's glad you destroyed his life. And he's sorry. From Trickle. His hammer is just to the
here. Boy.
Yes, sir. Okay. That's going in the journal.
This is a fine hammer.
Invari says thank you. Can we keep him?
We will talk to the Blue One.
To find that
here, the alchemist's hammer. His spirit is a nuisance.
Yeah, Anvari always was an asshole. Hell of an alchemist, though. Hand him over here and I'll melt him down.
What? You're going to melt down your friend?
A trapped soul's what I need to give your reward some extra oomph. You don't want it?
Father, we can't do that. Here, you hold on to him. He's really useful, I promise.
Fine. So long as he proves his worth.
Kid's a bit of a softy, huh? Well, he'll grow out of it.
Hey, Brock. We found something interesting.
See, you boys ran afoul of some travelers. Or them travelers ran afoul of you, more like.
Who are they? What do they want?
Dunno. Oh, you ask a lot of questions. Sure, I'm open. What the fuck ever? Thank you.
can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his blossom. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Good, right?
Better.
It's a fragment of a language cipher. We should look for more like this. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Freya end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough.
Freya was better to him than he deserved.
Out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people.
Know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Go!